Good morning, my dear students, and welcome to today's class. Dear students, I hope that all of you are taking care of yourself and you all are following all the necessary measures for the prevention of the spread of COVID-19. Dear students, at this point of time, we cannot be careless about taking care of ourselves and taking care of the people around us. So, in the best interests of everyone, please wear a mask and please do take care of yourself and maintain as much hygiene and sanitation as possible. Okay? My dear students, yesterday we did the poem A Legend of Northland by Phoebe Cary. Dear students, in that poem you learned that how an old woman, she was punished by Saint Peter for her greediness. Okay, so I hope all of you enjoyed reading it, right? Now today we are going to discuss the questions and answers of the poem. Okay, so all of you please take out your books and meet me on page number 67. Okay, so dear students, thinking about the poem, okay, let's quickly get to the questions. You all have to do just the first part. Remember this, okay? You don't have to do the second part. You have to do the first part only, in which 8 questions are there. And you also have to write the word meanings which are given in the NCERT, okay? So please write the above word meanings and do these 8 questions only, okay? Which country or countries do you think the Northland refers to? So I think I told you yesterday that the countries which are situated in the northern parts, and I hope you all know which countries are there in the northern region, okay, where the days are very short. Okay, Scandinavian countries, Norway, Sweden, may write some more. What did Saint Peter ask the old lady for? Very much given, right? The thing for which which was made by the lady 3 times. What was the lady's reaction? I think another very simple, how she behaved. Okay, you have to tell that. Please answer this question in only up to 50 words. Okay, these questions are not very long. You must write the answers within 50 words. How did he punish her? How did Saint Peter punish the old woman? Then, how does the woodpecker get her food? Okay, you have to describe what she does, what the woodpecker does. Okay, and then how it extracts the food. Okay. So another very simple answer. Do you think that the old lady would have been so ungenerous if she had known who Saint Peter really was? Now this is a very important question. Why? Because here your skills are being questioned. Okay, here it is being asked. You have to give your opinion. And I think you see, there are always 2 types of answer. In opinion questions, I always say that, dear students, if you write yes, it is also correct. If you write no, it is also correct. Just give me the right reason. Okay, yes ke liye kya right reason hai aur no ke liye kya right reason hai, wo relevant hona chahiye, wo chapter mein se hi hona chahiye, wo aapke observation mein se hona chahiye, then you will never lose marks in opinion based questions. And most of the time boards mein opinion based questions hi aate hain. Okay, so इसीलिए मैं आप सभी को कहता हूँ कि व्हेन वी स्टडी, व्हेन एवर यू वी आर स्टडिंग, वी शुड रीड द चैप्टर एंड वी शुड रिलाई ओनली ऑन दैट. ओके, इफ यू रिलाई ऑन एनीथिंग एल्स इट्स नॉट गोना हेल्प, जस्ट रिलाई ऑन रीडिंग द चैप्टर. What would she have done then? So, आपको ये बताना कि वो क्या करती. So, I think all of you can explain. Next, is this a true story? See, the title, if you read the title carefully, you will find out whether it's a story or not, whether it's a true story or not, right? Read the title carefully. There is your answer. Which part of this poem do you feel is the most important? So, again, anything can be your answer. But give the right reason. Okay? If your reason would be wrong, sorry, no marks. What is a legend? I told you that a legend is a story. Okay, it's a folk story which may or may not be real. Okay, why is this poem called a legend? When you will answer the sixth question, you will get to know. Sixth and seventh question, they are very much similar. Okay, why is this poem called a legend? Because there is no proof for any of it that it happened. Okay, there is no proof that a woodpecker is a old lady. Okay, here I have given your answer, but now I won't be telling you anything more. Okay, last one. Write the story of a legend of the Northland in about 10 sentences. So it is very simple. It is very easy. The story, I hope, is clear to everyone. Please write it. Okay, make a habit of writing short stories. Okay, 10 mark question in board will come for sure next year. Okay, the question will go nowhere, it will be there and you all have to face it. So please make it a habit that you write short stories. Okay, on Saturday also I asked you people to write a short story. If you have not written it, please write it, because 10 marks, okay, 10 out of 80 you will get from a short story. So please work very hard on your writing skills. Okay, work very hard on how you write a short story. Okay, so now we have completed this chapter. Okay, we have completed this poem. Let us now move to the next chapter, My Childhood. Okay, this chapter is an excerpt. It is a portion which has been taken from the book Wings of Fire. And who is the writer of Wings of Fire? The Missile Man of India, APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay, Abul Pakir Janul Abadin Abdul Kalam. Okay, who was our ex-president as well. Okay, so now dear students, let's open page number 68 and let's come to this beautiful chapter. Before you read, can you think of any scientists who have also been statesmen? Who's a statesman? Okay, statesman is a plural of statesman. Who's a statesman? Someone who cares only about the state, who is only concerned about the welfare of the state. Okay, hamare jo politicians hain, okay, they show themselves as statesmen. Kya wo statesmen hain? Nahi, because unke liye unki political ideology first hai, un first priority hoti hai. Lekin ek statesman ke liye kya first priority hoti hai? एक स्टेट्समैन के लिए फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी जो होती है वो उसकी स्टेट होती है, वो उसकी कंट्री होती है और उससे ज्यादा कुछ नहीं होती है. APJ Abdul Kalam, whose projects in space defense and nuclear technology guided India into the 21st century, became our 11th president in 2002. So, APJ Abdul Kalam, he was a statesman, okay? Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he was also a statesman, okay? Even though when he was in the opposition of India, he still represented India in the United Nations. Okay, very few instances are there, very few people are there whom you can call a statesman in the context of Indian politics. Okay, Indian politics mein zyada statesman nahi hai. So you can think about it, but unfortunately you won't get the answer. If you get the answer, you can tell me that in our Kaizala group, okay? If you feel anyone else is there. Okay, in his autobiography, Wings of Fire, he speaks of his childhood. So what are we going to read in this chapter? We are going to read about the childhood of APJ Abdul Kalam, okay? So I hope you all are ready. Wings of Fire is a very interesting book. It's a very good book. Sadly, it will be difficult for you all to find where to read it. I will do one thing in the winter vacation. I'll try to arrange the PDF of the book for you. Okay, I'll try to arrange the PDF of the book, and you can enjoy that book in whenever your winter vacations came, or you can do it yourself as well. Order the book from any Flipkart or Amazon if you want. Okay, aapki marzi hai. Agar aap Wings of Fire padhna chahe to, it's a great book. Okay, it is available there in the school library, but as you know, we cannot meet. Okay, but it's a great book, and I feel that all of you should read it. Okay, so now let's start the chapter. I was born into a middle-class Tamil family in the island state of Rameshwaram in the erstwhile Madras state. So, where was he born? APJ Abdul Kalam, he was born in Rameshwaram. Okay, he was born into a middle-class family. Okay, jo zyada rich nahi thi, jo na zyada poor thi. Erstwhile means former. पहले जिस स्टेट को मद्रास बुलाते थे, ओके? And you might have heard of चेन्नई. चेन्नई का पुराना नाम क्या है? मद्रास, ओके? और उसके आसपास का जो सारी जनता रीजन था, उस सभी रीजन को बुलाते थे मद्रास, ओके? अब करंटली उस रीजन को क्या बुलाते हैं? तमिलनाडु, ओके? करंटली हम उस रीजन को बुलाते हैं तमिलनाडु. My father, Jainu Labbadin, had neither much formal education nor much wealth. Okay, so his father, he had unko formal education, jo ek school education hoti hai, wo zyada nahi thi. Na hi unke paas zyada wealth thi, zyada rich nahi the wo log. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. So, unke paas kya tha? Great innate. Innate means inner. Okay? Andar se hi bahut sari wisdom tha, knowledge. Unke paas bahut sari internal knowledge thi. Unhe kisi ne sikhayi, but unke paas khud se thi. And a true generosity of spirit. Generosity means kindness. Unke jo behavior mein ek kindness thi, bahut zyada kindness thi. He had an ideal helpmate in my mother. Ideal means jo perfect hota hai. Okay? So ek helpmate, perfect helpmate the Mr. Jainulabdin ke paas. Wo kaun thi? She was the mother of Kalam, Ashiyamma. I do not recall the exact number of people she fed every day. Recall means remember. So he is unable to remember कि वो कितने लोगों को दिन में खाना हर रोज खाना खिलाती थी. But I am quite certain. Certain means sure. मैं 100% sure हूँ. मैं काफी sure हूँ that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family put together. So family में जितने members थे उनके उनसे ज़्यादा बाहर के लोग खाते थे. ओके उनसे ज़्यादा बाहर के लोग खाते थे. I was one of many children, a short boy with rather undistinguished looks. So मैं बहुत सारे बच्चों में से एक था. ओके क्योंकि पहले पुराने टाइम में फैमिलीज जो होती थी वो थोड़ी लार्ज होती थी. ओके सो ही वॉज अ शॉर्ट बॉय विद rather undistinguished looks, ordinary looks थे. ओके जिनमें ज़्यादा फर्क नहीं किया जा सकता कि एक होता है ना एक कि हाँ एक सेपरेट डिस्टिंक्टिव लुक है, एक सेपरेट पर्सनैलिटी कि हाँ अच्छा उसको देखा था वो वैसा लगता है. लेकिन कलाम APJ अब्दुल कलाम ही यूज टू लुक वेरी मच ordinary. उनको देख के कोई ऐसा नहीं था कि हाँ उनके बारे में कोई स्पेशल फीचर्स थे या कुछ स्पेशल था उनके अपीयरेंस के बारे में. नथिंग लाइक दैट वॉज देयर. Born to tall and handsome parents. So, जबकि parents थे वो good looking थे, वो tall लंबे थे height में, but Kalam he was not. We lived in our ancestral house. Ancestral means जो जिसमें ancestors रहते थे, जिसमें पूर्वज रहते थे. Which was built in the middle of the 19th century. So the house, it was built when? In the middle of the 19th century. Okay, 19th century mein bana tha. It was a fairly large pakka house. Okay, pakka here is of Hindi, strong house. Okay, well built house. Made of limestone and brick. Limestone is, I think, chuna. Okay, so pattharon ka, chune ka ghar bana hua tha. ब्रिक मीन्स ईट, ईट और चूने का घर बना होता. पहले घर अलग वे में कंस्ट्रक्ट होते थे. ऑन द मॉस्क स्ट्रीट इन रामेश्वरम. माई ऑस्टियर फादर यूज टू अवॉइड ऑल इन एसेंशियल कंफर्ट्स एंड लग्जरीज. ऑस्टियर मीन्स यू कैन सी इन योर बुक, इट मीन्स सिंपल. ओके सिंपल लिविंग के का वे ऑफ लिविंग था कलाम के फादर का. एंड ही यूज टू अवॉइड any comforts or luxuries which were not required. However, all necessities were provided for. Jo bhi necessities thi, jo bhi zarurate hoti thi, wo sabhi provided thi. In terms of food, medicine or clothes. So jo bhi inessential cheeze thi wo nahi provided thi, jo essential cheeze thi wo provided thi. In fact, I would say mine was a very secure childhood, both materially and emotionally. So Kalam ka jo childhood tha, wo bahut hi zyada secure tha. Okay? Secure kaise tha? Do ways mein baat kariye. Materially aur emotionally. Materially means material wealth ke baare mein, jo ek financial, jise aap keh sakte hain. Ki haan, financially, कोई भी प्रॉब्लम नहीं थी. देयर वर नो फाइनेंशियल ट्रबल्स. जो भी उसकी नीड्स थी, जो भी नेसेसिटीज थी, वो सभी कंप्लीट होती थी. इमोशनली हम बात करते हैं. इमोशनली मींस कि उसको मेंटल लव एंड अफेक्शन मिला या नहीं मिला, उसको केयर मिली या नहीं मिली, उसको सपोर्ट मिला या नहीं मिला. सो कलाम को अपने चाइल्डहुड में मटीरियली भी सपोर्ट मिला. ओके कि इसको कोई फाइनेंशियल ट्रबल्स नहीं फेस करने पड़े, और इमोशनली भी सपोर्ट मिला कि उसके पेरेंट्स ने उसे केयर और अफेक्शन दी और बहुत सारा प्यार दिया. ओके सो दैट्स व्हाट हैपेंड इन द चाइल्डहुड ऑफ APJ अब्दुल कलाम. ऑलराइट सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड टिल हियर ओनली. ओके नाउ if you have any questions, anything is not clear to you, please send me a message or give me a call or ask from me in the Kaizala group. Okay, I hope this much is clear to you, and you all have to do the questions and answers as well of A Legend of the Northland. Okay, and you have to read this chapter as well. Okay, so you have to do both the things. Please do both the things sincerely, and if you face any problem, I am here for all of you. Okay, do give me a call or send me a message. Okay, so dear students, now we are going to wrap our class. That's it for today. Thank you.